What's good, ladies and gents? Welcome to the MKO Pugilism Boxing Channel, where we talk all things boxing. Remember to like, subscribe, hit the bell notification, put it on all so you can get notified of all our latest content on the channel. So let's get into this one. Over the weekend, there was quite a bit of boxing, and one of these cards was a crazy card, bit of a, some people call it a circus card, which was Triller's latest card. And you know, with Triller, there's all sorts going on. They had a Puerto Rican singer on there. And as far as the action went, you had a few people boxing. The old boys were boxing, and you know, you had 50 Cent commentating, Sean Porter commentating, and let's just discuss this night, what happened on that evening. I'll just give you my thoughts on a few of these fights. And we had Evander Holyfield, who fought Vitor Belfort. And now this was originally going to be Oscar De La Hoya versus Vitor Belfort. Vitor Belfort is a veteran in the MMA world, cage rage champion. I think he was a UFC champion as well. He's 44 years old now, so he's past his peak, well past his best. And you know, he was Oscar De La Hoya couldn't make it, so we had Evander Holyfield as the replacement. Now, I'll admit that going into this fight, Evander Holyfield looked in tremendous shape. He looked, you know, he looked better than me. He looked better than a lot of young people. You look at the shape of him, just the physique and the body and everything, brilliant. Evander looks fantastic. And he's 58 years old. I think he'll be like 59 this week or something like that. So he's nearly 60 years old, but he looks physically in tremendous shape. But all the way in the lead up to this fight, he looked very slow on the pads and very slow in all the workouts that he was doing. And, you know, I think a lot of boxing people noticed it going in, and, you know, he could do the moves, but it was just like slow. It was just, he was hitting the pads and all his trainers and people hyping him up. Yeah, champ, we look good, champ. Giving him all that gas. But the reality was, he looked slow. You just knew he didn't have it anymore. Just watch the man on the pads. He just didn't have it anymore. You knew that that is a 58-year-old man. He's in great shape. He's got his, you know, but he can't box anymore. He's not in any condition. And apparently, I don't know if this is 100% true, but apparently Evander Holyfield is possibly part of the reason why the venue was switched. Because from what I heard, Evander Holyfield failed a medical in the first state where they were going to have the fight. And then, you know, he passed the medical in Florida or something like that, where, you know, wherever it was held. So, I heard so even that was a bit fishy, the fact that I think he failed the medical and then he had to go to another state to pass the medical. So he wasn't even really medically fit, from what I hear, to fight. And, you know, obviously Belfort, he's not a boxer, but he's a fighting man, big, powerful man, younger than Holyfield at 44. And as the first bell rang, you know, Holyfield, he still had his kind of shape, he shaped up all right, but again, it was just so slow, and just, it was really, really, he didn't even have his balance at all. And the first couple of seconds, Belfort jumps on him and sort of, you know, gets really aggressive and more or less just sort of bundles him to the ground. He loses balance, goes to the ground, and then, you know, a little bit later, a couple of seconds or whatever it was later, hits him a few times. I think Holyfield took about, I don't know, 8 or 9 punches in total, and, you know, fell down a couple of times. And then as he's getting pummeled again a bit, you know, the referee just jumps in and saves him. It was a good stoppage by the referee. He was very, you know, it was brilliant, because at least he didn't have that humiliation of actually being unconscious, actually being knocked out. He just got stopped on his feet. He wasn't very happy about it, but it's one of them where all through the whole fight, the whole minute or whatever it lasted, or seconds, he just had no balance. He had no coordination, no reflexes. He was just basically a sitting duck. He you know, he was never going to get through that fight. So good job by the referee to save him. You know, Belfort, he's no spring chicken, but at 44, he's still quite sprightly. He's still got a little bit left where he can still, you know, he can still fight a bit, still box a bit. So that's what happened there. It was a bit humiliating for Holyfield, but at the end of the day, good stoppage, stopped on his feet, rescued by the referee. Beautiful, as far as I'm concerned. At least it didn't take much of a beating. And then, you know, later down before that, you had Anderson Silva versus Tito Ortiz. Tito Ortiz, very good fighter in the MMA world. You know, he's a guy that I always remember. I'm not really an MMA guy, but I saw, you know, I'd seen a couple of his bouts in the MMA, blood and guts warrior. And he was saying in the lead up to this, look, I don't care about this beautiful boxing. You know, he Silva can do his kung fu and his Bruce Lee rubbish. I'm just going to go in there steaming and get, you know, basically saying I'm going to stick it on him. And, you know, this was one of them fights again, which interestingly, another one that ended in the first round, because Ortiz, you know, the bigger man, probably stronger man, just rushed in there after, went straight after Anderson Silva. But Anderson Silva's got, he's got all right boxing skills, so he was just on the back foot, just timing Ortiz, caught him a few times, and Ortiz wouldn't take a backward step, and Ortiz timed him with a beautiful left hand, left cross, just bang, straight in there, and Ortiz basically just ran into it, ran into the left hand, bang, and you could see as soon as that punch landed, Ortiz was basically unconscious, got hit with another one, bundled on, you know, fell onto the floor, spark out, and yeah, he was gone. It was good night. That however long that was, probably about 90 seconds of the first round, he just runs onto that, bang, because Silva's, he's not a boxer, but he's got good sort of good decent fundamental boxing skill. He's okay, he can box a little bit, so he just bang, timed him nicely, took him out. That was the end of the night for Ortiz. You know, he had no defense. He was just all, you know, he was just trying to steam in there, and just didn't work. So good on the Spider, Anderson Silva. He dedicated his victory to Bruce Lee and Kung Fu and Wing Chun, the stuff that Ortiz was taking the mick out of. But he was classy about it. He didn't celebrate when Ortiz was on the floor because he had that respect. So yeah, good victory for him. Quite impressive. And then further down the card, you had the other one that I saw on there. You had David Haye and his friend Joe Fournier. The fight that was happening because, oh, you know, they had a little argument in a beach somewhere, and their friends were asking, oh, David, who would win out of you and Joe? Do you know, Joe can box a bit. Who would win? Blah, blah, blah. And apparently David Haye laughed at the idea, and Joe Fournier goes, no, if it's right now, I'll beat you because you're always injured. I've seen your injuries in the gym. I've sparred with you. I can box a bit. I would beat you today, blah, blah, blah. David Haye said, all right, I'll call you bluff. Let's have a fight. So that's why this fight happened, for, you know, some silly reason. And all David Haye done was basically box exclusively, more or less exclusively, with a left hand. Just beautiful, nice movement, used his movement, boxed on the back foot, and he just jabbed up Joe Fournier. He even put him down with a jab. He was more or less exclusively using the left hand, showing his skill, making Fournier miss, making him pay with little left hands, and that's all he'd done, really. He just played with him for 8 rounds. You could see that David Haye did not want to hurt his friend. He didn't want to do any damage to him, so all he done, played with him for 8 rounds, and that was it. Fournier stood absolutely no chance. He was just so out of his depth that it was just laughable. It was laughable. It's, you know, it's like a beginner, an amateur versus a world champion. You know, it was like a joke thing, really. David Haye just played with the left hand, boom, 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 boom. Didn't let any right hands go. I can't remember. I don't think. And that was it, you know. And then the more interesting part of the fight was outside the ring, after the fight, where David Haye said, I can have Tyson Fury. I will come back to professional boxing if I get the offer for Tyson Fury, because I'm the kryptonite to Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury knows I'm his kryptonite, so therefore I'll, you know, if I ever come back to professional boxing, it's only for Tyson Fury. And yeah, it's one of them things where I think it might just be all hype talk. It might just be him just you know, being high on his victory, you know. But I think it could also, it could possibly be genuine, because he might, as Johnny Nelson was saying, he might just believe that he's got the tools to beat one, this one particular guy. You know, Hayes not talking about coming back to boxing full time, taking on AJ, taking on the other fighters, but he might just believe that he's got Tyson Fury's number. No one else's but Tyson Fury, so he might just come back for that one guy. So who knows? Who knows? And also, there was a good bit of comedy in this whole thriller thing, because you had Donald Trump commentating with his son, and you know, Donald Trump was, he's got a little bit of boxing knowledge, and he was making his jokes, and they said, "Ah, Donald, you know, would you ever fight?" He goes, "Yeah, I would fight Joe Biden, because, and Joe would go down very easy, you know, his hand movements." And he was a good laugh on the night, Donald Trump. He was, you know, him and some other MMA guys and whatnot were all there. You had my guy from the MMA was with him as well, and it was a good laugh. It was one of them cards where it's a good laugh. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on the whole Triller thing, Holyfield, Silver Ortiz, David Haye, you know, let me know your thoughts on that card. Till next time, it's MKO Pugilism over and out. I will catch you on the next one.